Slow down, you crazy child. You're so ambitious for a juvenile. But then if you're so smart, tell me why are you still so afraid? Where's the fire? What's the hurry about? You better cool it off before you burn it out. You got so much to do and only so many hours in a day. But you know that when the truth is told, that you can get what you want or you can just get old. You're gonna kick off before you even get halfway through. Ooh, when will you realize Vienna waits for you?
Hey Savannah, just sending you a message congratulating you on the huge accomplishment of graduating high school and getting accepted to University of San Francisco. It's just big time to see your growth from your freshman year until now. I'm really excited to see where you go from here. I think San Francisco is going to be huge for you, and it's going to be just, it's going to be a lot of fun. If I could give you one piece of advice when you're going to college, it'd be just to get out of your comfort zone, meet a lot of people, and just have a lot of fun. You're there for 4 years. You got to have a good experience. Just have a lot of fun and be safe. And we're here for you whenever. You can call me whenever. I love you. Good luck.
Congratulations, Savannah. We're proud of you.
Congratulations, Savannah. We're really proud of you.
Way to go. Savannah, my favorite memory is when I got to know you at Clark's wedding, find out all about your tastes, which are very similar to mine. Go June 6th birthday. Live it up. We know you're going to be great in San Francisco. You're super talented. Be yourself. You're an artist. We're behind you.
We're really proud of you. Super talented. Enjoy your journey.
Congratulations.
Bye.
Hey, Savannah. Brendan and Jason here, wishing you an incredible commencement. So bummed that you weren't able to have a terrific graduation like, you know, all the rest of us, but we know that you're going to have an incredible opportunity to be able to go to San Francisco and be living out your dreams, and we'll be just remembering all the great times of watching you grow up and just growing into the beautiful young woman that you are.
Congratulations, Savannah.
We love you so, so much, and we're going to miss you when you go to San Francisco, and we know that you're just going to light this world on fire. Take care.
Bye.
Bye.
Hi, Savannah. Uncle Tom here. I just want to congratulate you on your graduation. I feel bad for you, you know, with what's going on with this pandemic. We just, you know, have to get through it. Your play was great. I really appreciate having to watch it. I was so proud of you.
Hi, Savannah. We want to congratulate you on finishing high school, and I'm almost there.
Wow, you must have put in a lot of hard work.
We are so excited for you to start college!
Have a great time in San Francisco.
We love you!
Hello, Savannah. I miss you so much. Congrats, fellow grad. I cannot wait till we can celebrate in person. I just have two really quick memories I want to remind you of. First, you never want to hear about it again, but do you remember that god-awful Irish accent scene we did? I was just thinking about that and just remembering how awful it was. It was so bad. And second, I just want to thank you for being the absolute best stage combat partner. We killed that. We killed that scene. We're so good at beating each other up. Okay, I love you so much, and I miss you, and I'll see you as soon as I can.
Congratulations, Savannah. We love you. And good luck in your future ventures. Bye.
Congrats on graduating, Savannah. I'm so excited to see what the future holds for you, and I'm going to miss you so much in San Francisco. You're so talented both on the stage and off the stage, and it's been an absolute joy being your friend for these past 3 years, and here's to many more. Congratulations.
Hi, Savannah. This is the Door Dolls. Congratulations on your high school graduation.
I wish you the best in all the years to come, and I hope we can see you sometime this summer and actually celebrate in person. Bye.
Hi, Savannah. My advice to you going into college is to have fun, be adventurous, experience new things, meet new people. Don't take a single day for granted, because 5-10 years down the road, you're gonna look back and wish you had just one more of those days. It might not seem like much now, but not too far down the road, these are the days that you're gonna remember and cherish. So have fun, be safe. The more steps in life you take, the better you are for it. Love you. Good luck, Savannah.
Hi, Savannah.
Hi, Savannah.
Just wanted to congratulate you on earning your high school degree. That's wonderful.
Yep. And we hope you have a good time out at the University of San Francisco, and you get a nice degree, and you make a whole lot of money in your life.
Well, she doesn't have to make a lot of money.
Yeah, she does, in case, you know, one of us or both of us lose our jobs and we lose our car, and we'll have to go to one of my brothers for help.
Yeah. Savannah, yeah. Make a lot of money just in case, yeah. Okay? Have fun.
Yeah, and we'll be watching you.
Hi, Savannah. This is the Erky side here, Klosinski side. And we want to wish you a happy graduation, and we wish you all the best for your future. Words of wisdom, just stay true to yourself. Do what you want to do. Here's
that. So congratulations, Savannah. I remember babysitting you when you were little, and then how Grandma took me to the Wizard of Oz to go see you perform in that. Some words of advice I have are to not take things so seriously that you don't get to live in the moment. If you are doing things and being too serious, then you miss out on a lot.
Georgia, you have anything to say?
Congrats, Savannah.
That's very creative.
That's all. Leave me alone.
Congratulations. I have some advice. Stop caring what people think of you and do what makes you happy. You're living for you now, so do what makes you happy, follow your dreams, and stay off the drugs. That's important. It's hard to make your dreams come true when you're on the drugs.
Okay.
Thank you, Steve.
That's Dr. Steve.
For your health.
For your health. Okay, congrats!
Congratulations! Bye. Bye-bye!
Congratulations,
Savannah!
We're so proud of you.
We love you.
We love you. You go, girl.
Happy birthday, Savannah!
Congratulations, girl. Congratulations.
Happy graduation, Savannah. I know that this is not what we intended at all to be like our graduation, but I'm so excited for you. Like, this is such a big feat, and you've done it, you did the first 12 years of school. Like, that is crazy and awesome, and you should be really proud of yourself, because that's like not an easy thing to do. But anyway, I'm really excited for you, and I'm really excited to see where you go in the future, because knowing you as like smart and like creative and as special as you are, like, you're going to go so far. I'm so excited to see like where life takes you, where you take yourself. Like, I'm so excited for you, and you mean the world to me, and I hope we can hang soon and celebrate this. And I miss you and I love you, and I hope that everything's going great.
Hey, congrats on graduating. Savannah, you are literally my cousin. I love you so much. You're super talented and amazing. Made sure to video this at the cabin where we've spent like countless days having so much fun, and yeah, you're gonna do amazing.
Savannah, I am so lucky and grateful that we have got to be close over this last year. You bring so much joy and light and fun into my life, and I wouldn't trade it for the world. You are the bravest, most kind, most caring, smartest, most inspiring woman I know, and I am literally so excited to see where you go, because I know you're gonna go and do awesome things. Congratulations on our collective, your personal graduation from high school, and I love you. I love you. And I am so excited to be best friends for the rest of our lives. Okay, bye.
Hi, Savannah. Happy graduation. I'm so glad that we ended up going to the same school together and that we got to become friends, because you are such an amazing human being. And I appreciate your amazing personality. You're so genuine. It is so incredible. And also, you're so talented. Getting to see you on stage is breathtaking every time. I'm so in awe of your talent. So, thank you so much for being amazing. I love you so much.
Hey, Savannah, happy graduation. So proud of you. I don't know, just wishing you all the best wishes. I don't know, you're so cool, and I know that you're gonna make it so far in life. I'll always remember our New York trip, Colorado trip, the time that you and Cameron kidnapped me. I'm super proud of you, and I know you're gonna do awesome, awesome things. So, congrats, man.
Happy graduation, Savannah. I'm so happy for you. I'm so happy you're going to San Francisco. You're gonna kill it there. Overall, you're a great person. I love you so much. You're a great friend. I can't wait to visit you in San Francisco. Beach, yay! You're the best. So proud of you. Happy graduation. I love you. Bye.
Hi, Savannah. Congratulations on your graduation. We're so proud of you. We're going to miss you very much, but we hope you have a great time at college.
Well, Savannah, I just wanted to tell you congratulations on one of the first of hopefully many more big milestones in your life. In some ways, it seems like yesterday I was in your shoes, and other times when I walk by the mirror and see this gray hair, I'm reminded of how long ago it really was. But just know how lucky you are, and I'm sure you do, to have such a loving family surrounding you and supporting you. Wonderful mother and father and siblings and extended family. And just dream big. Nothing's beyond your reach. But at the same time, stay grounded and humble, and there's a lot to be said for keeping life simple. So anyway, best of luck to you, and congratulations.
And we're live.
Hello, Savannah. It's Buck and Peyton. We're just here to wish you congratulations. We're so proud of you. Just kidding. You totally froze them. Hey, congratulations. Peyton, what do you have to say to Savannah?
Congratulations.
Nice job, girl.
Have fun in college.
You're the best.
Oh, that's good.
Hey, Greg, we're going to pass this on to Greg and Desiree.
Hi, Savannah. Congratulations. So proud of you and all that you've accomplished thus far. So sorry that you have to go through graduation this way, but know that we love you and support you and look forward to your next chapter.
Yeah, congrats, Savannah. We're thinking about you. So great being able to see you last fall. And San Francisco is only an hour plane ride away, so hopefully you can come up here. We can come see you sometime.
Yep,
we'll
see you.
Looking forward to it.
Yep. Okay, Washington, you're on.
Tim's on mute. Okay. So let's go to Grammy and Grandpa.
Yeah, that was congratulations from Washington. Hey, we're really proud of you. Savannah, we're just 2 hours north. So if you just want to take off over Oregon and come on through right up to Washington. Go for it. Hey, congratulations. We're really happy for you, and hope that everything, it ends up being a great summer and a great first year in college. So take a holiday or two and come our direction and blow off going back to the Midwest.
Yeah.
That's what college is for.
There you go. There you go. Grandpa, Grammy, what do you got to say?
Go ahead.
Okay. I'm tongue-tied.
Okay, it's my turn.
I'm getting so emotional here. Anyway, I just want to congratulate you, Savannah. Down. You we're very proud of you. And we're looking forward to hearing all about college. If you want to talk about it, if you don't want to, we'll understand.
But, now, you always are supposed to tell Grammy everything. We won't tell anyone anything, like Mom and Grandpa. Anyway, Pat, congratulations, sweetie. Hope, sorry we cannot see you in your graduation ceremony, but maybe we can see you in a cap and gown. I'm not sure. Do you have a cap and gown, Mom?
Yep.
Okay, good. Then we want to have to see what you look like. You have to come over and or stand out in front and wave at us or something. But we want to see you in your cap and gown and some pictures. And I want you just to have a blast. I want you to do everything you're not supposed to do.
Ooh.
At least according to the parents and the old folks in the family. Just follow in all your aunts and uncles and cousins' footsteps. Have a great time. Love you, honey. Bye.
I'm Annie. I'm last but not least, I'm just going to tell you what I think. And so here's the deal. Hey, congratulations. Number one, congratulations. Number two, there's a couple of things you need to remember about college. And here's what it is. Do your homework during the week so you don't have to do your homework on the weekends. That makes sense, right?
Yeah.
Make sure you go to every party that you can. There's only so many of them, right?
Also do that.
Yeah.
On the weekend.
Here's the third thing. Do not flunk out. Because you don't want to go to the real world. Do not flunk out, right? That's right. That makes sense? Okay, good. And here's the fourth thing.
Don't graduate.
Here's the fourth thing. And the fourth thing is it's going to be over before you know it. It goes too quick. So that's why I was in for 7 years. It was actually. 7 year plan. Congratulations. So I hope you have fun. That's it. That's all I got to say. Lisa?
Congratulations. Say?
Mom's turn.
I'm stern.
No, I'm going to do mine later.
No.
I got to prepare.
Yeah.
We want to, just say something now. We had to.
No, I got to prepare.
Okay.
Well, we may send something later, too. We just did this as a group. We're going to do this every Sunday.
On three, congratulations. 1, 2, 3, congratulations.
Congratulations.
Yeah. That was really on together.
That's
we can congratulations. Sing congratulations like happy birthday.
All right. Well, I'm going to stop this recording.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Savannah Hoffman is moving to San Francisco.
Congratulations, Savannah, on such a big milestone. Really wishing you the best, and good luck next year when you head off to San Francisco.
Good morning, Savannah. Hey, it's your Uncle Tim. I just wanted to get a quick shout out to you and wish you the very best and tell you how much we love you and how excited we are for this next chapter in your life. And today's a big day, and I'm sure it just seems like you were running off to kindergarten and jumping on the bus and heading out, but it's going to go fast, and I know you've got a couple of months before you probably head out to San Francisco, but hey, it'll be one of those life-changing moments. I know when I left Prescott, it was a lot of anxiety and a lot of excitement, not knowing what the future had for me and all that, and you know, I'm sure you're feeling the same way, so enjoy today. Today will be a day of celebration. You've worked very hard in everything you've done and really done a terrific job, and we're very proud of you and love you. But when you head off in a couple of months, you know, always, you're going to get a lot of advice from a lot of people, and you know, take some of it. Parts of it you don't, but you'll figure it out. You're very confident and a bright young woman, so you'll do well. You know, just kind of chart your own path and get after it and enjoy life, and just know that it goes so fast. So if you ever need anything, your Aunt Tina and I are just a phone call away and an hour and a half flight, so it's an easy hop up to us, or us to come down and see you. So if you're ever feeling stressed or need us in any way, you know, it's real challenging. So don't anticipate that'll be a problem, but you've got a lot of life to live in front of you, a lot of great things, and boy, what a cool location. So you're going to have such a good time when you head out that way. And today's a celebration for all the hard work you've done and the new future you're about to begin. So, like I said, we love you and wish you the very best.
Hi, Savannah. That's Lucy talking to me. We're at Mindy's house, Mindy and Matt's house. Just want to wish you congratulations and all the luck in the world with the wonderful future you've got going for you. Be sure to enjoy every minute of it. Don't sweat all that big and little stuff. Don't let people get to you. Just, you know how to walk away. I know you do. You know how to work with people. You know how to handle people. You know how to understand people. You've had a wonderful 4 years. You have done so many things with school all the way through. I always picture you as Dorothy with her little red shoes. You did such a fantastic job, and from then on, you were just in there for anything that anybody would give you to do, you would do it. And all the way through, you had good spots in your shows, and I'm so sorry I had to miss some of your last ones here at senior year. Get involved. Get involved at school. Get into things. Get into the acting if you want to still do that. Just do, be in the background and design. Just have fun. That's what I want you to do. Don't get in trouble. Don't do things that you wouldn't wish you hadn't done. But have some fun. We love you. I love you. I hope that as you're growing older and I'm growing older, that we can have more time together, some good little visits, some lunches, maybe even take a trip, things like that. But you're going to the town that I've always, always wanted to live in. I almost went there instead of marrying your grandpa. That was what I was going to do, was live in San Francisco. So I hope and pray that you enjoy that town, because it's quite a place. And I'm coming to see you as soon as I can. Have fun. Again, congratulations. I love you, love you, love you. Goodbye, honey. I'm done.
Banana.
That's so much fun. And you're gonna have me if you want to. Yes. And this next part of your life is gonna be one of the best times ever. So enjoy it.
College. Let's get it.
The banana. Savannah, we're so proud of you. It is so huge to be done with high school and heading to college.
How about
San Francisco? That ought to work.
Can't wait to visit, honey. Yeah, we're gonna think we're all gonna come in your dorm and sleep in your bed.
Exactly. Yeah.
Thank you so much,
Dominic. Okay. Hey, Savannah, be ready now, okay? Because if you give us a green light, you're gonna have like six of us piling in your apartment here. We're gonna drive that curvy road.
Then all
we're
the way up
James
the hill.
Out to Alcatraz and leave him.
Yeah. Yep. Here we go.
Okay, Savannah, this means a lot more to Luke and James, because they're going to be ending up with GEDs. Yep. Oh, I guess golden.
No, it's okay. They're just not happy eighth grade. It's fine.
Congratulations, Savannah, on your graduation. Incredible accomplishment. So I was thinking about what I wanted to say to you, and I wasn't thinking about something really funny, or wasn't thinking about anything really particularly clever, because I don't think I'm either very funny or very clever. So I was just thinking about maybe providing some advice to you as you move forward with your academic career and your life. And one person that's always been a kind of a personal hero to me is Winston Churchill. Winston Churchill is an individual who, if you read up on him, he's an individual that failed many times. I mean, he had some catastrophic failures. He was ostracized, thought of as kind of a fool in many ways. And he was an individual who persevered above all of that and became, I mean, arguably the most impactful Briton in history. With his leadership through World War II. So one quote that he had I thought was very interesting, and I think it's applicable to not only your academic career but your life. But it's success is the ability to go from one failure to another with no loss of enthusiasm. It's something that I think it's more important how you respond to challenges as opposed to the challenges themselves. And if it is a situation, I know you're going to be doing great, but always keep that in mind, that it's often the failure that builds character. So anyway, congratulations again, and we'll try to come up and visit you as often as we can, and good luck.
Congratulations. We're so proud of you and love you so much, and I know how proud your family is. And you're almost like a daughter to me that I don't have, but I feel like you are. And
Hi, Savannah. Congratulations on your graduation. There are so many things I want to tell you, but here are a few things. Psalm says, "For you are with me, your rod and your staff." Remember, there are people who are used as a rod or staff or both. Some guide you, some hit you. It might hurt, but that's gonna make you who you need to be, who you are meant to be. For me, I had a lot of tough times and the good times. And when I look back, it was all needed to where I am now. So think about that when that comes. Just think about this. Is this person used as a rod or a staff? The other thing I want to tell you is find your tribe. Do not hang out with the people that has a negative energies bring you down. Life is too short. You protect your time, your energy, and you want to be with the people who are encouraging, who are honest, good people. Okay? The other thing I want to tell you is that success leaves clues. You do not have to invent the way. Always find the people you admire, you respect. Ask them for wisdom. Ask them for guidance. They actually really love hearing it, and they become your cheerleaders. They are going to help you. I hope you have a wonderful day today, and your life ahead of it is awesome. Bye.
Savannah Hoffman! Hi, Savannah, it's Mr. Foss. I can't believe you're graduating already. It seems like just yesterday that you were in our 3-4 class. Wait, I mean that you were a part of our 3-4 family. And now you're graduating. It's crazy how fast time goes. But anyway, I just want to say that I hope you're doing really well and congratulations on graduating from high school. And I know, Savannah, I just know that you are going to do such wonderful and amazing things in your life. Your positive attitude and your great work ethic that you always showed in eighth grade and that I'm sure you continued to show in high school, those two things are going to take you to wonderful and amazing things in life. And the other thing I wanted to mention, and one thing I always appreciated about you, Savannah, is that you weren't just a great student at our school, you were a great person. You were kind and helpful to others, and being a great person is another thing that's going to really take you far in life. But anyway, I just wanted to say congratulations and good luck with whatever it is you're going to do in the future, and keep your neuroplasticity going. I hope you remember what that means, but keep that neuroplasticity going, and you have such a bright future ahead of you, Savannah. And congratulations and have a great
Hey, Savannah. Congratulations on graduating and getting into the University of San Francisco. We're so proud of you and know that you do great things. The fun memory we have is too hard to explain, but you'll understand. You're in Anna's basement. We're playing hide-and-go-seek in the dark. We're so glad we met you in fourth grade and been friends ever since. Love you so much. Bye!
Hi, Savannah. Happy graduation. I just wanted to say I love you and I miss you, and I am so excited to see where you go and what you do. Wish I could hug you. Love you.
Congrats on graduating.
Good work, Savannah.
Good job.
Sick.
Hey, Savannah, congratulations on graduating this year. I hope that you are as proud and impressed with yourself as we are with you. You have grown up to be a brave and compassionate and creative an incredibly thoughtful individual and have worked really hard to get to this point. And we are excited to be celebrating with you from afar. I hope moving forward you continue to seek adventure and that you take risk and you grow from your experiences and that you find out what you're passionate about and you pursue it. And we love you and we think you're awesome. Congratulations and woohoo, 2020.
Savannah, where do I start? How can I say how I feel about what you have accomplished in your time in high school? and it's just crazy. I just have to congratulate you and tell you how proud I am of you. Just seems like we had a lot of fun together. Maybe it's because our birthdays had the same. I don't know, but I do know that I just love to spend our birthdays together. When we went to Denver, I was so excited because we had a chance to do a one-on-one. But now you're leaving me. What am I gonna do? What am I gonna do? You know what I'm really, really gonna miss? Is those hugs. Man, oh man, you are one big hugger. And I know when you hug me, there's a lot of feeling in it, a lot of meaning. But I do want to congratulate you. I'm very proud of you. I'm proud of when you did those plays, and you were especially that last one. I just couldn't believe those lines that you had to memorize. But now you're going off to another chapter in your life. You're going to San Francisco. What a place, what an exciting place for you. And I tell you, and I know Grammy and I are gonna come out and see you, because it's just gonna be, it's so much fun for you. I just have a special bond with you. Maybe it's because we're birthday buddies. Maybe it's because we're always looking for something free. Always remember, this is one thing I want to tell you. Always, always remember that on your birthday, look for the free stuff. Birthday free stuff, that's our motto. And I'm going to continue. And every time I find something free, I'm going to think of, where's my friend Savannah? My special friend, Savannah. Not that I don't love all my other grandchildren, I do, but we sure have a special bond. I love you, and I know that you're going to do well no matter what you do. You've already proved that in high school. You've already proved that you have got a very, very good head on your shoulders. So Savannah, congratulations. I love you. And I want you to write me every day, every day.
Hi Savannah, congratulations on your graduation. I am so proud of you and everything that you have accomplished during your time at SCCCA. It has been such a pleasure to work with you, especially this last January on Mad Woman. You are a delight, and I know great things are in store. Keep in touch.
Good morning, Savannah. Hope you're feeling well today. It's raining here today, and I know this virus has messed up a lot of plans for graduation parties, etc. But you're going to graduate anyway, and this is only the first graduation. Remember that. So, since I was not around when you were growing up, I don't have a whole lot of memories, except I remember that I was always the tallest girl in my class and hated it. And I know you can probably remember being that way as well. However, now it has paid off, because you are beautiful, tall, and striking. And I think you'll do very, very well. Just words of wisdom. Kathy told me I'd never remember, so I've got these words of wisdom on my counter, which I have to put up there, so I read it every day. And this is what it is. Accept what is. let go of what was and have faith in what will be. So you're off to sunny California. I know you'll miss the snow like I do, but it'll be a whole new adventure. Congratulations and good luck.
Hi, Savannah. Hey, this is Uncle Dan. And I just wanted to say congratulations on your graduation. I know that there's a train coming by right now, so we might hear it blow its whistle. But at any rate, I just wanted to say congratulations. It's a big day. You're going to graduate, which is awesome, which is great. Hey, I hope that you have a lot of fun at graduation and that you have a lot of fun at school. I know school's right around the corner and it's going to go real, real fast. In fact, you're going to get there and then you're going to blink and it's over. So a couple of things to remember while you're at school. Number one, make sure that you have fun. Just go out and have fun. Have as much fun as you can. You know, but number two, stay in school. Make sure that you stay in school and get good grades because you got a lot ahead of you and you don't want to miss out by flunking out. So stay in school and have fun doing it. And then the third thing is make sure you come home. Come home. Come home and see your parents. Come home to see your family. Know that we're always here for you whenever you do want to come home. And if there's anything you need from me, just let me know. Just give me a call and I'm here for you. So that's what I wanted to say. Also, I wanted to say again, congratulations. And I love the woman that you've become, the young lady that you are. You're fun. You know what you know what is right and wrong. You know what is important to you and where you want to go in your life. And so hold on to that. Hold on to you. And before you know it, you're going to wake up and you're going to be graduated or go get your master's and graduate. And it's all going to happen so fast that it's going to make your head spin. But before any of that happens, I just want to say I hope you have a great graduation. And if you've already had it, I hope you had a great time. So I'll see you soon. And congratulations. See ya.
Hi, Savannah. We just wanted to share our favorite things about you. My favorite thing personally about you is how you're so funny and you always bring laughter to any situation or any circumstance.
And my favorite thing about you is your intelligence and drive for every situation.
We also wanted to share a few tips for you going off to college, even though we've never been. We just wanted to say, party hard because you're boring right now, so go party. All right, bye, love you.
Bye.
Hi, Savannah. Where do I begin? I'm going to try to get through this without crying. We'll see how it goes. I think that I hope over the years we have been able to give you the life lessons that we think will be helpful to you as you gain more independence and through your adult life. You know, really in parenting, that's really what it's all about, is to help you prepare for adulthood. I just want you to know that you'll decide what success really means to you. It's not what it means to all of us. It's not what society believes success is. What matters to you and what's important to you is what brings you joy and what fulfillment that you have for life it really is. Find your passion. Don't let other people steer you the way that they believe your passion should be, because ultimately it really is your life. And I have no doubt that you are a person with sincere, strong passion. And wherever that passion takes you is where life is going to lead you. So don't be afraid of that passion, because it's actually larger than you. Gratitude. Okay. Gratitude can change your whole day. Find gratitude in little things, Savannah. It could be gratitude in the fact that it's a sunny day, or gratitude in the stranger that said hello to you. Or it could be gratitude in the big things in life, that you're healthy and that you're strong and that you have a strong family. But just find gratitude every day, and that is what's going to make you happy. Nurturing. Please, please, please nurture yourself. Take care of yourself. Be good to yourself. Don't be too hard on yourself. I know that you do have a tendency to be hard on yourself, and when you find the good in you and you focus on all that you are capable of and all your strengths, you're able to be good to yourself. But even in the little things, be good to yourself. So if it makes you happy to get a good latte or macchiato for the day, treat yourself. Treat yourself to relaxing in the park, in your hammock. Treat yourself to, I am gonna get something special, like pick up that cute bracelet for myself, or just do little things to treat yourself and be good to yourself, because don't expect others to be good to you. Be good to yourself. Love big, okay? That I don't have to tell you much about, because that is one of your huge, huge many strengths, is that you love big. You love your friends big, you love your family big, you love your animals very big, you love nature and this earth, and you love all people. That is one of the things that I absolutely adore about you, and find is such an incredible quality about you, is that you love big. And how inclusive you are with everyone. And embrace the differences of other people. So, you know, as you and I have had many, many conversations, there's so many people that are different in their values and different in what they find to be important. Just continue to learn from other people. And find out, you know, what their passions are and what makes them special. But kindness, my dear sweet daughter, kindness will take you everywhere. Be kind to yourself, always. Be kind to yourself, but always be kind to others. That's the best gift that you can give yourself, and the best gift that you can be and give to others and to show to others. But allow yourself to feel kindness. So if someone gives you a compliment, Savannah, believe that it's genuine. But really, really take that kindness and just say thank you. Don't second guess yourself that it didn't, that it wasn't genuine, or that you didn't deserve it, because yes, in fact, you did deserve that. You're gonna find your path. You're gonna make mistakes, but know that the hardships that you might have are all meant to mean something, and for you to learn from those. So, everything will pass, honey. Everything. Everything passes. When there are times that you feel lonely, or when there's times that you just need some love from your family, your friends, please reach out. because we are here for you, okay? Let's stop myself from crying. Okay, one of the things I absolutely adore about you is that you are an independent thinker. Keep that quality, girl, okay? Just keep that quality, because your independent thinking is what has gotten you so far. You're not willing to live within a box like so many others are. What you, my sweet girl, does is you have a desire to learn and to really expand your knowledge, and that is what has gotten you so far. That and your strong, strong will, okay? So strong will, with you and I, we've went head to head at times. But you know what? I love that about you, Savannah. I love that you are strong-willed. In your adult life, there's gonna be many times you're gonna have to gain from that strength and continue to be strong-willed. The power of pause. When there are times that you want to react and that you've got that strong emotion, there is huge power in pausing. So pause, let it sink in before you respond. So many times we want to respond to get our point across. And one of the huge lessons in life that I could teach you is that sometimes we just need to pause. We all need to. So just take a pause. That's all. Wisdom comes from stepping back. Step back, take a pause, and think. And sometimes you don't need to respond at all. Sometimes it's not worth it, right? Also, we've talked about this throughout your life, is there are people in your life that are only meant to be there for a short period of time. You are gonna learn from each person, and take from some and take from others, but each person that you come across, whether it's only for a short time or whether it's a friendship that you have for a lifetime, some people are only meant to be in your life for a small period of time. That doesn't mean you don't value the relationship that you had and the friendship that you had and everything that you gained from them. Just know that they gained a lot from you too, okay? So it's really important to let go of relationships if you need to, and hang on to the ones that give you the strength and the love that you need. Stay positive if you can. I know that's hard for all of us. But the more that you can turn your mindset around and think of things as a positive, just know that life will be easier. And tomorrow is always a new day. It's a reset button every day. Continue to persevere and move forward, okay? Through the last several years, our family has went through some challenging times. But what our family did is we continued to persevere, okay? So just keep that in mind, Savannah. Just continue to persevere. And when you feel like you cannot persevere, reach out to those that give you strength, because those people will help you persevere. What else do I want to say? Be there for a friend that needs you. under any circumstance, be there for others. I cannot stress that enough. When you're there for others, it not only helps them, but it also helps you in your heart. Just be there for others. But I want to end in this note. I'm beyond proud of you. See, I can't even speak. I'm beyond proud of you. I really am. I admire you beyond belief. And I could not be prouder for the success that you've worked so hard on your education. You work so hard at everything you do. And honey, my sugar girl, I love you beyond belief. I'm gonna miss you, but I'm looking forward to where life brings you. I'm looking forward to this new adventure in your life, and I'm beyond proud of you, honey.
Hey, Savannah. I've decided I'm going to do this to a song. Not that the song has anything to do with it, but just so that it would give me a time frame so that I know if I'm rambling on or if I need to cut it short. So here goes. Here's the soundtrack to our conversation. You know, when I was thinking about doing this, it was that thought of what to say. And every time I think about you, I remember that first night of having you in my arms, standing in front of that window, and you're crying like a new baby does, and just having no clue what the hell I was going to do. You know, I didn't know how to be a dad. Sometimes I still wonder if I do know how. You know, your mom and I have tried as much as we can to instill you with the wisdom and knowledge. But the bottom line is, you're going to go off and we just have to trust that you're going to know what to do. And that can seem scary at times, but you've always known what to do. I mean, you're intelligent and vibrant and so full of life. And that's the reality of who you are. You don't need anybody to tell you what to do. Just trust yourself. Trust your instincts. Take risks, take chances. But know every time that those risks and chances come with a cost. And just make sure that that cost is worth what you're doing. I know you're going to do great things. You're going to make us proud. You always have. You've never once made me feel anything less than proud. And that's the truth. I mean, a lot of times parents talk about how it's like they had the dream child, but you know, you are one of those people that can fill a room with your entrance. Don't let that go. Don't ever let anybody take that away from you. Dream big. And do the things that you want to do with life. We'll always be here. We're your safety net. That's our job. Your job is to go out and take over. I love you. I love you more than anything in the world.
When will you realize Vienna waits for you?
May you have auspiciousness and causes of success. May you have the confidence to always do your best. May you take no effort in your being generous, sharing what you can, nothing more, nothing less. May you know the meaning of the word happiness. May you always lead from the beating in your chest. May you be treated like an esteemed guest. May you get to rest, may you catch your breath. May the best of your todays be the worst of your tomorrows. Whoa. May the road less paved be the road that you follow. Whoa. Well, here's to the hearts that you're gonna break. Here's to the lives that you're gonna change. Here's to the infinite possible ways to love you. I want you to have it. Here's to the good times we're gonna have. You don't need money, got a free pass. Here's to the fact that I'd be sad without you. You to have it all. Slap bracelet. May you keep the chaos and the clutter off your desk. May you have unquestionable health and less stress. Having no possessions, though immeasurable wealth. May you get a gold star on your next test. May your educated guesses always be correct. And may you win prizes shining like diamonds. May you really own it each moment to the next. May the best of your todays be the worst of your tomorrows. Whoa. May the road less be the road that you follow. Oh. Well, here's to the hearts that you're gonna break. Here's to the lives that you're gonna change. Here's to the infinite possible ways to love you. I want you to have it. Here's to the good times we're gonna have. You don't need money, you got a free pass. Here's to the fact that I'll be sad without you. I want you to have it all.